Nobody's got anything to say.
You're running for president. What is there to say?
Tell them I said yes.
Shirley's story was one that was important to tell when we realized how many people did not know who Shirley was.
I'm gonna have to find you a campaign manager. Needs to be somebody black.
Needs to be somebody good.
I didn't realize how much I didn't know about Shirley Chisholm until I started doing research in preparation for the film, but she's one of my heroes. And I think that her story is really important.
Let's get you elected president.
All right.
There was this little Bayesian, Brooklyn-born woman that inspired so many to move beyond their comfort zone.
She was a political pioneer. She was a pioneer as a woman in politics. She was a pioneer as a black woman in politics.
No one could tell her no. She was just a maverick, a Goliath.
We brought that unbought and unbossed spirit to making this film.
I am running for president.
That's right the hell on, Mrs. C. I mean, that's great.
She really stood by her word, and she fought for what she believed in. Shirley was a powerful person. A lot of what stands out to the young people at the time was that she was immovable. She fought for everybody.
People say I'm crazy. Am I crazy?
Yes.
But maybe that's what it takes to make a difference. And I hope to God it happens.
Regina King is the quintessential actor. The dignity and regalia that she expresses and channels it directly through Shirley Chisholm will give you a bird's eye view of humanity at the birth of a godlike figure, because that's what she becomes in this. She inspires humanity to become something greater. That's something I wouldn't miss for the world.
That's our campaign. We'll build from there.
All of the research that we had done on Shirley and the people that we got to talk to who actually knew Shirley, the one thing all of them said was that they've never seen anyone that can curse someone out so well without using curse words.
They're not your servants. They're given their time. You're drawing a check, but you got too much mouth to do how you get paid.
That's just brilliant. As a filmmaking team, we were like, we have got to make sure people can see everything that makes Shirley, Shirley.
As Speaker of the House, it is my honor. Gentlemen, madam, welcome to Congress.
I was faced with the biggest challenge ever with trying to embody this woman who is probably one of the most unique beings I've ever studied.
Join me as we go down the Chisholm Trail by 1972.
Get ready for one of the great all-time performances of a historical figure.
In my opinion, she's gonna bring Shirley to life so effectively, I think that people are really gonna be moved and inspired.
The research she put in to it, her embodiment of this character, it is downright astonishing.
I owe you everything. But right now, I need you to do as I ask.
Her dialect alone was terrifying. I had an amazing dialect coach, Erin Washington.
Shirley is from Guyana, and her education was in Barbados. So she has this beautiful mixture of this forward, bright Caribbean sound.
Then how am I not gonna try for everybody else?
And then with this education in the British schooling system, that allows her to really, really articulate and makes people think of British.
I am the candidate of the people of America.
And then we have this New York sass.
I'm a congressman.
You ain't no man.
Maybe we should find your mother.
So we balance with that triangle, Caribbean, New York, and British, and we play inside of that space.
When you see me coming into this chamber, vanish.
What we need to do is find where Regina and Shirley intersect, because that's what Shirley was always doing. She was finding how she was gonna meet you so that her dialect would change.
Little girl, the first thing you've got to do is vote.
Just the historical significance of Shirley aside for a second, I feel one of the most important reasons why we need to keep telling stories like this and in this kind of format is to continually humanize people of color.
Love you, Shirley.
I don't need your love, darling. I need your vote.
What Shirley would say about a film being made about her, the reason for doing it was to honor her. But I guess a part of me feels like she would embrace it because we made the choice to tell a slice of her life. Better to talk about this moment, this lightning in a bottle moment in American history. That was Shirley.
Those of you who are able to vote for the very first time must use your voices and let the politicians know that the government belongs to all the people.